rebelled again. It's always about me with you. Me, me, me. I'm thinking bigger picture, and you're worrying about getting into trouble. You know what? You really are something.
What bigger picture?
We are gonna take over the school.
We are not taking over anything right now.
Time and tide wait for no man, my friend. But it seems they do wait for a wannabe tough guy who's nothing but a little girl.
You're full of it.
So you keep telling me. Look, now come on. I promise you, after this, things are never going to be the same again. Oh, I'm so excited. I should have stopped taking those pills ages ago.
Yeah, right. Whatever you say, Gary.
Thank you. Maybe that could be useful for me.
So, Jimmy boy, here we are,
the hole, the place where this school separates the men from the boys,
the wheat from the chaff, and all that nonsense.
Okay, so what's that got to do with standing up to people, keeping them in line?
This is where I stand up to you, my friend.
What are you talking about?
I know you hate me, Jimmy boy. I know you said all that stuff about me behind my back.
What are you talking about?
Don't play innocent with me. You want to run this school? I want to run this school. Only one of us is going to make it. And it's going to be me!
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and morons, I give you Russell!
Oh, man.
Gary, now I hate you.
I know.
Russell, go beat that little jerk who said that nasty stuff to me about your mom and those color guard animals.
What? Come here. Russell wants vengeance.
You and me,
I've taken dumps that had more brains than you, friend. No, I'm taking over this school, and you're just a liability. See you around, moron.
Well done, Jimmy.
Yeah, great. What a waste of time. You all right, Russell?
Yeah?
Look, I never said anything about your mom or farmyard animals.
You did it?
No, but I want you to stop bullying weak kids.
Why?
Because there are a bunch of kids around this place who need a beating, and you're picking on a few who don't. So I want you to leave me and him alone.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Bad Russell.
With Russell pacified, I could be forgiven for thinking my troubles at Bullworth were over. But this place is a rotten onion. Peel off one stinking layer, and there's another even smellier one beneath.
Well, Jimmy, word on the street is you're something of a pugilist.
No, sir. I never pugilized in my life.
Really? And that you've been saying some entertaining things about me and some barnyard animals.
No, I never said that.
Well, I listen to things, Hopkins. You try and stay out of trouble. Now go see the cook down in the kitchen. Helping her might teach you some humility.
Okay, sir. Hey, new kid. You're that guy that beat up Russell. So, what's it to you? Hey, listen, we like to box, the noble art and all that. Why don't you come down by our gym in old Bullworth Vale? We should definitely hang out. Yeah, I've heard a lot of things about you. Yeah, whatever. Okay.
I really, really, really need some help. Oh, Jimmy. Why don't they let me? I just...
Boys and girls, I'm Ms. Peters, and I'm going to be your music teacher this year.
I know I'm a good teacher. I wonder if she's mad at me.
Are you asking me, Anna?
Can you help me, please? Just like 1 second.
Hey,
okay. I need to get back to the girls' dorm. Would you please walk me home? It's just awful. I mean, it's so wrong.
That'll do. You ready to train? This was my favorite competition back when I had a...